Yo, what's up guys, Julia here, and today I'm going to be doing a Nintendo Switch Pro Controller unboxing. We bought this at GameStop for 70 bucks, and I didn't like the price of it, but for some reason GameStop has to price it. We came back home from our 3-hour trip. We went to some places, and we went to some banks and all that stuff, some boring banks, until when we got here at home and I decided to do an unboxing. And pardon of my brother in the background. So this is the box of it. My friend Carles used to have this, but he gave it to Andoni. This is how the side it looks like. And on this other side as well. Here we have, I think, how to use the controller. This part looks simple. All you have to do is connect your dock to the TV, connect your HDMI to the TV. But let's not get to that right now. We're gonna unbox this. If I can get it out. Okay guys, so I already unboxed this side. Now for the other side. I did it. Oh wait. Gotta put this back on there. It's actually hard to record cut when you're unboxing things when you're using scissors or a knife. Don't worry, I'm careful with these scissors. Okay, how do I do this? I'm trying to cut it and it won't let me. Got it open and here we have the cord for the controller. This is a USB-C type. A USB-C type. So, I'm gonna try that later on. Let me get the controller out. Man, this is hard. Getting the controller out when you're doing an unboxing video. Got it. It's in here. So now, wait, is there like any manuals in here? There's something. Piece of cardboard. I don't think there is a manual in here. Nothing in the box. I will keep this box in the shelf. We're gonna take this to, the room. If y'all are wondering why I have the band-aid on, or the other band-aids, which I'll show it to you in the mirror, I don't know if you can see it, but I have like four. No wait, I have three band-aids, make that five band-aids. The reason why I have five band-aids, even though you can't see the band-aids from here, is because my skin was starting to peel off. So I'm gonna put this right over here, next to my Switch, I think. Okay, I didn't put it next to the Switch because it was so high, but I put it next to the MacBook that I received on my birthday. Now let's unveil the controller. Let's unreveal this. Oh wait, but I gotta take this to my room. Okay, never mind. My mom's going into... I think, my room or any of the rooms that we have, if you remember from the room tour video. So unbox this. I mean, I'm gonna feel like... There, I got it. Let's take a look at this. It's kinda heavy, but I think I will enjoy this. I am gonna take the protector off this, or the plastic. Taking it off. There we go. So this is how the controller it looks like. We have these buttons. A, B, Y, X. The plus and minus buttons. This button right here, which is a circle button. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's right there. And a plus sign. No, wait, I'm sorry, that's the home button. The D shape, I mean the D-pad of this, and some analog sticks, I believe. Pretty cool. And a sync button, so where you can sync this to your Nintendo Switch. And here we have the USB-C charger, in case if your, you know, controller dies. Got the tape out, now I'm gonna get this out, if I can try and get it out. Oh man, it's taped on this. Okay, I think I might have to dump it out. And I got it. I know that this is trash, but I'm gonna keep it in the Pro Controller box in case if we get a refund, in case if it breaks or something. The reason why I have my Nintendo Switch box up there is because, in case of a refund, we sometimes keep the boxes that we buy, but some people throw them away. But that's not all we bought from GameStop. We bought this, the Need for Speed Most Wanted. I've been dying to get this, and I finally got it. It was $10. And we don't like the prices that they give out at GameStop, because they're freaking expensive. This is the Power Up Rewards card on the back, in case if you, I think, want a membership from GameStop. I'm gonna open it up, and oh wow, it actually is different, and it comes in this stupid plastic GameStop PS3 DVD cases. This is the limited edition. My Xbox looks different. Look, I'll show it to you. It's like this. I thought that this was gonna be, one of the artwork on there. But since GameStop didn't have that, I feel kind of sad. The artwork is the same, but it's different on the 360. It's like this. This one's the limited edition. What else did I bought from GameStop? Great question. Put these aside. We got, already showing you that, the Genie car from Aladdin. They had this at GameStop. It was cheap. I think it was about $1.99 or something. For $1.99, it was cheap. And I actually liked this. It was at GameStop. I don't think it was on sale. I also saw some ads that they were gonna have some Fast and Furious Crossroads on the Xbox One and PS4. So make sure to check that out. And yeah. If you look inside, you'll see that there are more chairs. It's like a limousine, but it's a genie car still. The wheels work. So that's what I mostly do with all of my cars. I rub the wheels like this in case if they work. I got it from my mind, I think, and yeah. I accidentally opened this while we were riding in the car, but I got an odds one out blind bag. I'm never going up. And I got the animated one. And this one, I think, is either the sad one or the surprise one. It's one of the squishy versions. And I used to test out everyone's squishy when I was in elementary school. And I actually liked it. The school that I went was at Cedar Grove, and it was my favorite school. I go to Palmetto, not right now, but that's where I go. I am gonna test this out. Got my Switch over here, if you can see the controllers, and this, the dock. So I'm gonna turn the TV on. It said Chromecast built in when I was putting it closely. I'm changing the output and it's in HDMI 2. I know that you don't care, but that's where the intro is. I mean, where the input is. So I'm gonna turn my Switch on. It's on. I haven't played my Switch in weeks. So I'm gonna take my controllers out. One. And can I get it up? Yes, I got it. Two. I think I may have to get another controller, but not another pro one. I want like another one, but that holds up this and that it isn't wired, because I hate those things. So I just went into the controller section and it's telling me to connect this there. So I am gonna connect this USB-C into the Switch, which is right here. Gonna put it here. Got it. Okay. And then here is my controller. And I'm doing it, and I want to connect this where the dock is, because, well, it's telling me to. Or here's another option. I think you can just press the sync button, but I don't want to, because I don't feel like doing it. So I'm going to connect this to the controller. I got it halfway in, just let me connected here. Wow, it's actually paired, but it doesn't show me the player icon. See if I can press this. Yeah, it appeared. I'm charging it right now because, well, that's what I'm doing. And I don't know if you can see it, but green things just popped up on the controller. So I know that this is dangerous, but I'm gonna use that while I'm playing some games. So instead of using this, the controllers on the Switch, I think I'll be using this and see if I can get the hang of it. So right now, in Pardon of the Brightness, I'm gonna be playing Asphalt 9. It's one of my favorite games. Oh wait, I'm not connected to the internet. Let me connect my Switch to the internet and I'll be back. I keep forgetting that every time when I press B, I always think that this is a Xbox controller. Well, it isn't. So, yeah. So, I already connected my Switch to the internet, and I'm about to play Asphalt 9. So, I'm gonna test this to the Switch and see if I can get the hang of it. I think I'm gonna use it for 1 week. If only I made a YouTube video about it. But one problem, and I did not mean to show my mom's face. I don't have a tripod with me. I have a selfie stick, which even though it isn't a tripod, I call it tripod myself because so that way, because I can't fit a selfie stick onto the tablet, so I don't know how to record this. Can't invite any friends over, and I don't know what to do. If only there was a cameraman here. Or camera woman or something, I don't know. Hey, time for Asphalt 9. Why do I keep forgetting that? Why do I always think that this is an Xbox controller? I'm gonna play it and I'm gonna try the controller out. I think I'll be using this for 1 week. And then I'll see if I can get the hang of it without using the controllers that's on the Switch. So this is the car that I'll be using. This is a Nissan 370Z Nismo, and I'm gonna play the game. Okay guys, so I lost, but I'll try harder real soon. In the controller we have some chips on there, the inside of it. It's translucent, this controller, and on the back as well, it's translucent. So I don't know where to put this because my Switch is in here. So I don't know where. I'm thinking putting them in one of these cabinets, but I don't want to because this was expensive. I hate it when GameStop makes everything expensive, but they have to for some reason. So I know what y'all are probably saying. Why do you have two universes?